Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Sue Donham's front row seat at a family reunion. Welcome home, Denny Shackleford. Starring Joe Campanella. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company and Lazy Boy Recliners. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Spending time away, especially when one's exile is not by choice. Denny Shackleford used to work for two men who operated a machine, a political machine. And now Denny has grown tired of vacation time and wants to come back. Today, the story of a homecoming. Picture this, a hot tropical morning on a small Caribbean island.
Denny, hey, Denny, listen to this.
Shut up, Sticky, you'll scare off the fish.
Oh. Get any bites?
Yeah. The flies are eating me alive. Oh, man, am I sick of this place. I need some action.
Hey, I got just the thing, Denny. Birds.
Birds?
Yeah, fighting birds. It's the big sport around here. Mucho peso can be had.
Nah, I don't want to hear about it.
Okay. Forget the bird. Hey, there's a sailboat race on Sunday.
I'm sick of sailboat races and dog races and birds and fish and bananas. Ah. I'm sick of this place. I'm going back to the States.
Now, Denny, let's not start that again. We made a deal with Schatz and Turnbull. We can't go back till the next election. Hey, where you going?
To send Jill a cable.
Well, what's the rush?
There's a boat leaving here Sunday for the States. When it sails, we're going to be on it.
Gay what?
Yeah, what is it?
It says here we're going to be investigated.
Oh, not again.
Yeah.
Where does it say that?
Right here in Ken Warwick's column.
Ozzy, what are you doing buying that paper?
I didn't buy it, I stole it.
Good, I wouldn't want you paying Warwick's salary. He costs us enough as it is. Half our people are out of circulation.
What are we going to do about him, Gaylord?
I've got something planned for Warwick.
Bullet in the head, maybe, huh?
Nah, that's too messy. We don't want to get rid of Warwick.
We don't.
He's going to help us out.
I don't get it, Gaylord.
Come in, Jill.
I got your message.
Well, now, you're real prompt.
What do you want?
How's Denny?
Denny who?
Yeah, her.
Denny Shackleford, the fugitive. You remember Denny.
Okay, cut the games. What about Denny?
Oh, I'll bet he's homesick. That's what he said in the telegram, isn't it?
How do you know about that?
Oh, chill. The birds didn't hear we lost the election. They still sit on telephone wires.
Well, there could be trouble when him and Sticky Guanco come back.
Why? They've been gone over a year.
What Ozzy means is it could be dangerous for Denny if he wasn't careful while he was here. After all, he's wanted for murder.
Denny didn't kill that witness. You set him up. You're the ones who'd be in danger if Denny came back.
Yeah, maybe a little. But don't forget about you and Nick Shivers. Denny wouldn't forget if he knew.
It's over between Nick and me.
I know that, Jill, but the birds...
I don't know what's on your mind, but I still like Denny, and I'm not crossing him.
Did I ask her to? Did I ask her, Ozzy?
You didn't ask for nothing.
But you will.
You know me too well, huh?
Much too well.
Go ahead with your plans, honey. Meet Denny and Sticky at the harbor and hide them out. But hide them where I say to.
Why should I trust you?
Oh, I guess I haven't made myself clear. Either you do it my way, or Denny Shackleford's a dead man.
Hey, Denny, how about a little shuffleboard? That Okie in the flowered shirt's just dying to give away his money. Go on, play him.
You play. I'm busy thinking about getting back home.
Hey, you look worried.
What you need is action.
Want me, sir, ready to come for you?
Oh, thank you. Here.
Thank you, sir.
Well, who's it from?
Let's see. Hey, it's from Joe. convinced your friends you had to come back. Everything's set. We'll meet you at pier and explain. Love and kisses.
Yeah, maybe Schatz and Turnbull fixed it so we're in the clear.
Ah, it's Jill who fixed it. I knew I could count on her.
I don't know, Denny. You can't trust Broad.
Ah, Jill's different. She takes care of business.
Well, I don't like the part that says she'll meet us and explain. Explain what?
Now look who's worrying. Come on, take me to play shuffleboard, Sticky. You need some action.
Chronicle, Ken Warwick speaking. Yes, I'm listening. Well, when does this homecoming take place? When? Who is this? Hello? Hello?
You got a minute, Ken?
Hi, Larry. When's Mayor Boyd due back?
Well, if you don't know, how should I? I'm just the police.
Can I trust you to keep the lid on something?
My lips are sealed. What, you got something new on Schatz and Turnbull?
Could be. I just got an anonymous phone call. A blockbuster, if it's true. Denny Shackleford's back in town.
Denny, Schatz and Turnbull are being investigated again.
They're always being investigated for something.
I don't know how safe it is for you to be back.
See, what did I tell you?
Oh, shut up, Sticky. Hey, what gives? Town's in the other direction.
You'll be staying out of town for a while. You have to.
Why? Cops don't know I'm back.
And there's a cabin by a lake up in the hills.
Oh, no, we'll be sitting ducks. We ain't got a gun between us.
Oh, here's two. One for each of you. But I don't think you'll need them.
Oh, baby, you're the greatest. There, you feel better?
No.
Shut up, Sticky.
Well, Ken, it looks like your telephone tip is on a level. Shackleford was on that phone.
And a couple of things are bothering me, Larry.
Like our timing, for one, huh? What are you missing by, 2 hours?
The mystery caller knew the name on the fake passport Shackleford used for another. And the babysitter. The ship steward's description fits Sticky Guapa to a T.
Guapa? Wasn't he part of Schatz and Turnbull's operation?
Right, illegal gambling. Guapa disappeared about the same time Denny Shackleford dropped out of sight. Now, why would Schatz and Turnbull want those two around?
Well, I probably don't own it back.
If they do, I'm sure there's a reason for it. Hey, drop me back at the office, would you, Larry?
Sure.
I think I've got the makings of a story.
Hello?
Schatz, this is Jill. Denny and Sticky are at the cabin.
Oh, that's nicely done, honey.
They're not very happy.
But it's so beautiful by the lake.
You know what I mean. I told them I'd ask how long they'd have to wait it out.
Oh, I shouldn't imagine they'll be there too long. Hey, thank you, dear. Bye.
What's the matter? Don't our guests like the accommodations?
Oh, I see. Come on, your wheeze is most unbecoming. If you can't control yourself, I'll have to ask you to go into the next room. Now, I must have quiet while I make this call.
Yeah, Gail. Sure.
My phone.
Yeah, I better get some.
No, stick around, Larry. Chronicle, Ken Warwick speaking.
See? Denny Shackleford is back.
Another call, same voice.
Denny's a very dangerous criminal, Mr. Warwick. He kills people.
Tell me, sir, why are you calling to tell me
now,
this?
Now, don't talk. Just listen. Take Route 27 North, about 10 miles up in the foothills, where you'll see a lake down by the road. Now, there's a cabin there. That's where Denny Shackleford is right now.
How do I know he's there?
Oh, you'll find out. He'll probably be shooting at you. With all the guns and ammunition he has, there should be lots of fireworks. If I were you, I'd take along plenty of help. Happy hunting.
Hello? Hello? My story's shaping up, but somehow I get the feeling somebody else is writing it.
Denny, supper's ready.
Yeah, might as well eat. Nothing else happens around here. What'd you make?
8 to 5 says you can't guess.
Beans.
You win.
I'll show you what I think of winning.
Hey, who's going to clean that up?
Leave it. We're getting out of this joint.
But, Denny...
But nothing. I'm going buggy with the quiet up here. We came back for action. Man, the squirrel's got more going for him than we do. When's Joe coming back?
She's got to talk to Schatz and Turnbull. Until then, we're stuck, Denny, baby. We ain't got no way out.
I'm for walking.
You're crazy. We'd be picked up so fast, we couldn't...
Hey, what was that? Thought I heard something.
Shackleford and Crowco! Shackleford and Crowco!
Denny!
Shut up.
It's the cops! We've been fingered!
How's your shooting eye?
We know you're in there. Come out with your hands raised.
You want us? Come and get us.
Jill must have turned us in.
Shut up. You're going to use this gun.
Against all them? But the odds?
Stop or we'll shoot!
Keep running!
Get busted for giving the media people that phony information about the shootout.
I'm printing the same story, Larry. Two fugitives killed in gun battle. By the way, how's Guaco?
Well, he'll live, but he won't be talking for a while. Shackleford must think he's awful clever. He doesn't know he let him get away.
Well, Gaylord, no more Denny Shackleford.
You killed him. You killed Denny.
Oh, now, there, honey. I did nothing of the kind.
You set him up. They didn't stand a chance.
Lady, you got it all wrong.
I'm not going to let you get away with it.
Ozzie, take that gun away from her, please.
Stay back, I warn you.
Bullets don't bother me, lady. I'll take that gun.
You asked for it, Turnbull. I couldn't have missed from this close. How did you...
Thank you. I'll take that gun. Ozzie wears lead underwear, honey. Even so, he doesn't like being shot at. Ozzie?
Oh, yeah?
Wait a minute. That's enough. You'll mess up the office. Finish her off somewhere else.
Like where?
Someplace where she won't be found.
Chronicle, Warwick speaking.
Ken, good news, I think. We arrested Ozzie Turnbull. Pulled him over for speeding. He's in jail right now.
You jailed him for speeding?
Well, not exactly. It seems he had a passenger.
Shackleford?
No, it's a girl by the name of Jill Foster.
What do you have on her?
She used to go with Shackleford.
Does she know where he is?
Well, it's hard to say. Maybe a while before we can talk to her. She was riding in a truck, see?
Uh-huh.
She's beat up pretty bad. Turnbull hasn't said so, but it looks like he was on his way to dump her.
Oh, where is the girl now?
The hospital.
Meet me there in 10 minutes.
Right.
What does the doctor say, Larry?
Well, we can't see her yet. Maybe we ought to just, pick up shots.
No. He'd love a false arrest. Where is the doctor? I want to speak to him.
You got to make a phone call. His is the last office down the hall, Dr. Miller.
Right, thanks.
I'm telling you, it's Jill Foster in that room.
Where's Ozzie?
I don't know. The cops brought her in a few hours ago. I just found out about it. Another doctor admitted her.
Well, has she said anything?
No. She's still unconscious.
Well, keep her that way.
I can't. The place is crawling with cops. And a reporter is on his way.
Ken Warwick?
Someone's at the door.
Miller, that girl better not talk.
Dr. Miller, I'm Ken Warwick from the Chronicle. Could I speak to you, please, when you're through on the telephone?
No. Surely, Mr. Warwick. Have a seat.
Like you were saying, Dr. Moore?
All right, Miller. Send an ambulance to my office and hurry it. One driver, two uniforms. You got it?
Yes, doctor. Will the patient need anything else?
Yeah. Keep that reporter away from the girl.
Now, Mr. Warwick, what can I do for you?
When can I see the foster girl?
Oh, not for some time, I imagine.
Oh. I'll wait.
Hold it right there. Don't turn around. I got a gun pointed at your head. We can wait for your friend, Mr. Schatz, together.
You made good time. Now, where's the Hey, Denny.
What's the matter, Schatz? You look pale.
I'm sorry, Mr. Schatz.
Shut up, you.
But I thought you... Well, I heard it. You and Guaco...
Shot in the back? Where are you heading? I said where?
The hospital.
I should bring you in DOA, but that's murder, and I haven't killed anyone yet. But I'll give you this for old time's sake. Okay, you strap him in the back real tight and then come up front with me. You know, for once, I think I'm going to like hearing sirens. Okay, friend, you first.
What's the matter with you, Davis? I told you no sirens.
I'm afraid it's an emergency, Dr. Miller.
Denny? Denny Shackleford.
Still putting people to sleep, Miller.
Drop the gun, Shackleford.
Huh? No trouble, officer. I'm giving myself up.
Larry, pick up shots. I just talked to the girl.
Why, if it isn't Denny Shackleford.
Warwick, right? I remember. Don't bother looking for shots. He's resting in the back of the ambulance. I've got lots to tell the jury about him and Turnbull.
Going somewhere, Dr. Miller? We couldn't talk to the girl, eh? Well, come on. You too, driver.
Well, Larry, Denny's testimony did the trick. It took a long time to get enough on shots and Turnbull to put them away.
Yeah, it's too bad Shackleford has to do time, too.
He'll be out before long. Come in.
Hey, guys, have I got something for you?
What is it, Sticky?
Well, there's a party up in the cabin where I got shot. See? And Denny and Jill asked me for you to come. Well, it's sort of a going-away party for Denny and me. Starts at sundown. Can you make it?
Well, I'm off duty.
I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Good. That'll be $5 apiece. You see, we got a raffle going.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Welcome Home, Denny Shackleford is an original radio drama adopted by Sue Donham. Joe Campanella was heard as Ken Warwick. Featured in the cast, Alan Bergman, Julie Bennett, Peter Leeds, Dawes Butler, and Johnny Hamer. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Colas, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.